alien races. A to E. Agarians, or Agartians, a group of Asiatic or Nordic humans who, sources claim, discovered a vast system of caverns below the region of the Gobi Desert and surrounding areas thousands of years ago, and have since established a thriving kingdom within, one which has been interacting with other planetary systems up until current times. Alpha Draconians. Reptilian beings who are said to have established colonies in Alpha Draconis. Like all reptilians, these claim to have originated on Terra thousands of years ago, a fact that they used to justify their attempt to retake the Earth for their own. They are apparently a major part of a planned invasion which is eventually turning from covert infiltration mode to overt invasion mode as the window of opportunity, the time span before international human society becomes an interplanetary and interstellar power, slowly begins to close. They are attempting to keep the window open by suppressing advanced technology from the masses, which would lead to eventual Terran colonization of other planets by Earth and an eventual solution to the population, pollution, food and other environmental problems. Being that Terrans have an inbred warrior instinct, the Draconians do not want them, as to attain interstellar capabilities and therefore become a threat to their imperialistic agendas. Refer to Els. Altarians. Alleged reptilian inhabitants of the Altair stellar system in the constellation Aquila, in collaboration with a smaller Nordic human element and a collaborative Grey and Terran military presence. Headquarters of a collective known as the Corporate, which maintains ties with the Ashtar and Draconian collectives, Draconian, Ashtar Command. Amphibians. Similar to the Saurians or Reptiloids, yet being hominoid creatures with reptilian as well as amphibian-like features and are semi-aquatic in nature. May have once lived on land, yet became more aquatic over the centuries. They have been encountered near swampy regions, rivers, etc., and have been known to attack people without being provoked. It is interesting that some types of greys and reptiloids are believed to be semi-aquatic, having webbed fingers and toes. Anakim. Also referred to the Els, short for Elder Race or simply as the Giants. Referred to in ancient Hebrew tradition, this race is allegedly tied in with a branch of ancient humans who broke off from mainstream humanity because of their vast size which had developed over the centuries, possibly as a result of a genetic anomaly. They are said to range anywhere from 9 to 11 feet and in some cases even 12 feet in height, although in configuration they are remarkably similar to international humans. Are said to possess a means of molecular condensing and expansion which allows some of their kind to mingle among humans on the surface. They have allegedly been encountered in deep and extensive cavern systems below the western part of North America, as far north as Alaska, as far south as Mexico, and as far east as Texas. They are believed to have interstellar traveling capabilities. Andromedans. The Andromedan Council has ordered all extraterrestrial presences on the planet, in the planet, and on the moon to be completely out of our space. They want everything that CT, benevolent or not, off the planet. This will be very interesting since there are over 1,833 reptilians living in our planet and over 18,000 greys living underground and on the moon. The Council would like to see how we will live with each other when we are not being manipulated by ETs, as we have been for the last 5,723 years. Anunnaki. Nimrod was a worshipper of Anu. Nimrod, unlike Abraham, did not believe in an unseen deity. Nimrod wanted Abraham to worship Anu, the Most High known as Elon Elon El. Nimrod was the founder of the city of Babylon, and his most renowned architectural influence was the construction of the Tower of Babel. Nimrod also had a city named in honor of Anu. It was to be called Calne or Calne, Genesis 10:10, meaning Fortress of Anu. It used to be an ancient city in Babylon, Mesopotamia. K. Drakkon is often associated with Nippur, which is one of the seven cities that was inhabited by the agreeable Anunnaki. Nippur was also known as Kodesh. It was originally called Nibruki, meaning Earth Place of Nibiru. It was the city of Enlil, the Anunnaki Elohim, son of Anu and Antum. Not only was Kalni one of Nimrod's cities, there was Babel or Babylon, the ancient site and capital of Babylon near the Euphrates. Erech, a city 40 miles northwest of Ur, toward Babylon on the left bank of the Euphrates, and Akkad or Akkad, a city in North Babylon, and a part of the district around it are all a part of the land of Shinar, called by many the country of two rivers, literally meaning plains of the flatlands. In the land of Shinar, today called Iraq, is the place where the ancient Sumerians came to set up an advanced civilization, where you'd find pictograph cuneiform writings, excerpted from the Spell of Leviathan 666, Spell of King U, by Dr. Malachy Z. York. Antarcticon. This is allegedly a secret area of operations for both human and reptilian beings. It is said by some that Aryan Nazi scientists actually developed disc-shaped aircraft capable of very advanced aerial performance, and that swastikas have been seen on a few aerial discs. They may be piloted by a purebred blonde, blue-eyed Aryan race. There appears to be more than one blonde human society involved in the UFO scenarios, and especially subterranean human societies may have developed blonde hair due to lack of sunlight. There does not seem to be anything more than a peripheral connection between the Antarcticans, the Telosian and the Pleiadian blondes. That is, we will refer to the Antarcticans as the Aryans, the Telosians as the blondes, and the Pleiadians as the Nordics, in order to discourage confusion. The Antarcticans may consist largely of batch-consigned purebred blue-eyed, blonde Aryans who became victims of Hitler's obsession to create a super race, and as suggested by Harbinson and others, most of these may be controlled through mind manipulation and implants, being human drones who are used to keep this hidden society functioning. A massive joint humanoid reptiloid underground system called the New Berlin is said to lie below the mountains of Neuschwabenland, Antarctica. It is said by some sources that this joint human alien force has spread terror through this sector of the galaxy, conquering and committing untold atrocities against the peaceful inhabitants of other worlds. The famous abductee Barney Hill, who along with his wife Betty was abducted by Zeta Reticulum Greys in 1961, stated under regressive hypnosis that he had encountered an evil-eyed German Nazi working with the Greys on board the craft. It is claimed that the original treaty with the Greys was established by the Bavarian Thule and Illuminati societies as early as 1933. And this collaboration was brought into America via the CIA, which was established with the help of American Nazi Fifth Column agents, as well as European Nazis who were brought into America through Project Paperclip and other operations. Antares. Alien group that was affiliated with the Montauk Project, but only as observers. They look human. Arcturians. Arcturus is one of the most advanced civilizations in our entire galaxy. Edgar Cayce, further information here. Atlans. These are humans, usually described as being benevolent by comparison to other groups, who are said to inhabit vast and complex cavern cities beneath southern Brazil and surrounding regions. The term Atlantean or Atlan, in reference to these races, has been placed upon them because of the fact that these cavern networks along the east coast of Brazil were reportedly once a part of the antediluvian Atlantean Empire. The present inhabitants have no direct genetic relation to the ancient Atlantean society, which is said to have controlled these cavern systems several millennia ago, but are referred to as Atlanteans simply because they are descendants of those who rediscovered and inhabited the ancient Atlan installations. As in North America and other continents, both common and gnome-like humans have been encountered here, some of which possessed advanced aerial or disc technology. The Tolosians claim to have some connections with South America, especially the Mato Grosso region where a sister city named Posada exists in a large cavern system underground. Afin. They come from constellation Lyra. They call themselves Afim Spiensi. Small in stature and with blue spotty skin. Their planet is called Crimea AIP3. Their technical developed level is such that they can get here from their planet in only 20 Earth minutes. They do not need oxygen. A large percentage of their atmosphere is hydrogen. Colonize 10 planets in a non-violent way. When they are close to humans, they cannot be seen. Unless they want to. But humans will feel a certain amount of unexplained anxiety. Their spaceships are small and sphere-like. They visit us to study human deviation. This activity is important to them, in determining the further development of the human race. Alcabata. Aggressive race that comes from the constellation Perseus. They have over 5,000 ships, and have colonized 10 planets on their own. Considered one of the parasite races. Abduction of humans is frequent and ongoing. Purpose unknown. They do not like to interact with other alien races. Last seen on Earth, September 1, 2001 in Canada. Suspected to have been involved in several airplane crashes. Most known case, Korean Airlines Flight 007, over Russia, USSR, 1983. The Russians took the blame for it. Alamyuk Strat 163. They come from Jupiter. After a reputed lost battle in ancient India against Reptoids, exact race and date was not specified, they were forced to leave our planet, which they have been visiting for about 200 years. They have resumed their visit since 1948. As far as the book says, this race is technologically extremely advanced. Their ships, for the most part, are invisible and they also wear a suit that makes them invisible as well. Enana. This race are what we humans call Martians. They come from the constellation Gemini. For thousands of years, they have had bases on Mars, where they mine a sort of gold-like mineral. The first recorded visit on Earth was in 1235 BC, in Japan. According to the book, they were last seen on Earth in Madagascar in 2003. Algruulix. They come from the constellation Cetus, near Deneb Kaitos Shemli. Although they are often confused with reptilians, they do not share anything with the reptilians except the appearance. Their height is around 2 meters, 6 feet, and can live up to 350 years. This is one of 21 races that have more than two genders. This race have 8 different genders, and all of them can reproduce when in sexual contact with each other, no matter which. Their purpose to visit Earth is unknown. Last spotted in Lima, Peru, in December 2004. Akkart. This race comes from the constellation Sextans. They crashed one of their ships, near the town of Vagina in Brazil, in 1996. Two of the occupants are under USA custody. They paid a huge amount of money for them. According to the book, they have the fastest ships among all alien races. Last seen on Earth February 2002, near Vagina in Brazil. Again. Eik. They come from constellation Ophiuchus, near Praia. considered by other races as peaceful. The purpose of their visits is unknown. They never stay long on Earth and do not interact with humans or other aliens here. They mostly use Earth as a stop, to quickly gather something they may need, before they leave to their real destination. They are mostly nocturnal. Their ships emit a bright orange light and are, most of them, not all, octagonal in shape. Last spotted near London, England, in May 2003. Alabram. They live on a planet that lies beyond the Andromeda galaxy. The beings on this particular planet have a similar physical appearance to us, but with great enlarged diaphragms and lungs. This is because the oxygen on this planet is so weak that an Earth person could not exist. This planet has millions of people on it like Earth. Their birthing process is different than us in that they carry the fetus for a shorter gestation period in their stomachs, and regurgitate it when the time for giving birth. At that moment the new baby is extremely small. It reaches full maturity in only 7 years. The beings on this planet have extremely large brains and are able to absorb information through osmosis, and are very telepathic. They drink liquid similar to water and live on foods that are grown in caves and tunnels hollowed out beneath the surface of the Earth. The reason for this is the star that serves as their sun is so hot that it would burn the plants if they were planted on the surface of the planet. Bavi. The inhabitants of the planet Bavi look like the typical blondes, and as such belong to the Liran Caucasian group. In other words, they can walk among us without being recognized. Phenotype A1. On Bavi all human activity is concentrated in a metropolia, the rest of the planet being left to nature and to the animals which inhabit it. Men and women are on a footing of absolute equality, and have a lifespan which, though not unlimited, runs to several centuries. Their age is, so to speak, arrested when they attain their majority. Bernarians. Inhabitants of the Bernard's star system. Although not much has been written about them, it seems that human beings, at least in part, control this star system, along with the Orange. Whether the Saurians have any influence or not is uncertain, however some sources indicate a possible collaboration similar to that within our own solar system. Bootians, aka the Suleimani Confederation. They originated from constellation Boots, approximately 30 to 40 light years from Earth. They are malevolent towards humans, a part of the Orion group. Bootians are generally viewed as hostile towards the human. Physically, they are said to be chameleon or reptilian-like, and originated from the Draconian reptilians. Bootians are allegedly quite intelligent, and have small snouts and large reptilian eyes. They eat human flesh because they view humans as a food source. Their negative activities include implantation, infiltration and control of galactic civilizations and societies, activities they are thought to be conducted here on Earth as well. Their reptilian heritage leads them to believe that they are the ultimate warriors, and that other races are inferior. One of their goals allegedly is to dominate the Earth entirely and are also working in deep underground bases on the Earth, working with the Draconians and Greys to take over the Earth. They have also exchanged advanced technology to the government. According to Alex Collier, the reptilian civilizations that we know today in Boots are all genetic manipulated half-breeds of the original Chakaris. Burrowers. another mutation of the saurian or serpent race that is capable of burrowing through the earth. Possibly quadrupedal as well as bipedal, these have been known to use their natural boring abilities to create artificial tunnels like moles, or even spontaneously produced cave-ins. The latter has allegedly been used in attempts to entrap or kill unsuspecting intruders into the underground domains. These may possess a highly developed biosensing system. Blue people. The blues are said to have translucent skin, large almond-shaped eyes and small of stature. The main issue of their teaching was pursue your passion, follow your own way, do your own thing, don't be pressured into being anything but what and who you are. The information about the blues comes from Robert Morningski, a Hopi, Apache dancer. According to Morningski, the first alien contact started about 1947 to 1948 with the Greys contacting the US government to form a treaty with them. Another body of aliens arrived, called the Blues. The Blues advised the government not to deal with the Greys, saying it would only lead to disaster. They told the US to follow your own path. They said they would teach with peace and harmony if men would disarm and listen. The military said no deal. So they left, but a few decided to remain and stayed in northern Mexico and Arizona and made a treaty with the Hopi Indians. These aliens are known by the Hopi as Star Warriors. The Greys started monitoring the Blues. So the Blues had to flee the reservation and go into hiding. A few of the elders went with them. The Hopi legend is that there were two races, the Children of the Feather who came from the skies, and the Children of the Reptile who came from under the earth. The Children of the Reptile chased the Hopi Indians out of the earth. These evil undergrounders were also called Two Hearts. Butters. Being that dwells in spiritual darkness. The person may be intellectually developed. The Batu are normally associated with nightmares, abductions and the taking of small children. They usually come around at night. The grey aliens who do abductions falls into this category. The reptilians are also part of this group. They are usually not very physically attractive. Apparently there was a visitation long ago by Butters, called Wakshashas, who were negative, powerful, aggressive beings. Sishans, or Tau Sishans. A human race of Mediterranean or South American appearing, tan-skinned humans. Very similar to Caucasian humans on Terra, except for slight differences. Slightly pointed ears, higher physical density for their size, slightly broader nose, 5 inches tall on average, and often wear short Roman or crew-style haircuts. Tau Ceti and Epsilon Eridani are said to be a major convergence of extraterrestrial-human activity, and are said to be in alliance with the Pleiadians, who in turn, according to contactees, have federated alliances with the Vegans, the Amites, and others. The Sushan alliance with the Pleiadians and other societies who have been victimized by the Grey Predators, is based on a desire to establish a common defense against their reptilian nemesis. The inhabitants of Tau Ceti have been heavily involved in the war with the Lizzies. Interestingly, already in 1920, a contactee was told about the Norkans, a race of blonde inhabitants of a planet circling Tau Ceti, who migrated to Earth some 14,000 years ago. Tau Ceti is also one of the systems from which modern scientists have received clear radio signals, that are believed to be an indication of intelligent life. Chameleon. Reptilians genetically bred to enable themselves to appear human. Also less humanoid appearing reptiloids who use a form of technosis, molecular shape-shifting and or laser holograms to produce an outward human appearance. Reports of these have surfaced from underground joint operational facilities near Dulles, New Mexico, Dugway, Utah, Groom Lake, Nevada, Deep Springs, California, and Fort Lewis, Washington and elsewhere. They are reportedly involved in some type of infiltration agenda. These infiltrators can appear remarkably human outwardly, however at the same time retaining reptilian or neosaurian internal organs. Often described as appearing bulge-eyed with scaly, hairless skin behind their disguise. One report alleged that the chameleons may utilize artificial lenses to conceal slit pupilled iris. Some claim they are genetically bred mercenaries who are part of an advanced guard of a planned silent invasion takeover of human society. Chians. Physically, the average Chian is slightly taller than humanity, although they're more delicately built. Like the majority of species on their home world, the Chians are hexapods, possessing four legs and two arms. They have long narrow faces with a downward pointed muzzle, long fur stretches from their heads to mid-back. While their fur may naturally be brown, black or red, many dye their hair in intricate patterns. Although the home world of Chia is today a garden paradise, this was not always the case. Over a millennium ago, the Chians nearly destroyed their race and their world in a nuclear war. Huge swaths of land were irradiated, the seas blighted, and the whole planet slumped into a nuclear winter. The survivors of the war were those few who had survived in underground bunkers. The remaining Chians eked out an existence in sealed domes and underground bunker systems, as they worked over the course of centuries to restore their home world. Even today, many of the techniques used in modern terraforming efforts are a result of the Chian's experiences on their own home world. Diros. An underground species. Some believe them to be human while others see them as non-humans. These are the beings from which comes our legends of leprechauns and trolls. Unlike the Diros, these little beings are considered demented and cannot be trusted. The Diros try to keep them under control and keep them from having excessive power. The Diros live in underground tunnels, cities and under the sea. This group of insane cave dwellers were called Samanian, meaning the obese ones, or Samim, abandoned Diros, or as they are called today, Diros, which is a combination of the words detrimental and robots. These Samanians or Diros really exist. The chief is Yabuan. The Samanians are constantly in conflict with the group of beings called the Duanis, who hold the same belief that they too will take over the planet one day. They are born by hatching from eggs that are 4 to 6 feet in diameter. They grow to 7 feet and are extremely obese. The Diros who live in the caves are degenerated so much that they don't have much intelligence. Dracos, reptilians. Location, home system, Alpha Draconis. Draco is the name of an astronomical constellation, of which Thuban is the alpha star. This constellation is the home of the Draconian Empire. Thuban is an Arabic word for snake. These are the most known and feared of the reptoid species. There are at least three. These are highly advanced entities but viewed as being of a negative, hostile or dangerous disposition, since they regard humans as a totally inferior race. Supposedly they consider Earth their ancient outpost, and want to have complete control over it, because their planet is becoming unable to adequately support life. They are considered one of the most technologically advanced species, but they prefer to work in the shadows, using that as an advantage for their progress or plans, agenda. The highest order of the Draco caste is the white-skinned Draco beings. Some experiencers have reported seeing white-skinned Draco beings interacting with the greenish-brown-skinned Draco, reptoids and various grey types. In these cases, all other non-human entities, including other Draco, greys and reptoids, treat the white-skinned Draco as if they were their kings or generals. They can travel interdimensionally, most races can't, and some of their high-ranking members also have the power to become invisible. They have a presence on thousands of planets, and have at least colonized 500, by means of infiltration, within the leadership of each planet. They have three main bases on Earth, one near the Bermuda Triangle, one somewhere off the coast of Denmark, and one off the coast of New Zealand.